What's up, folks? Good morning, good morning, and good morning. This is your boy, Deacon the Django. We're here again at another episode of The Devil's Advocates. So, everybody, good morning. I'm here with my illustrious co-host. She's here. We all back this week. You know, last week we had to take us a little hiatus because we got the call. We kind of like had the itis tail on.
Y'all had the cooties.
Yeah, we had some everything. I mean, everybody was under the weather. You know, of course, we had a weather change. It is finally fall here.
Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah. I'll tell you what. These summers, you know, you got your crispy, crunchy black. You know. So, you know, it is fall here and the weather was changing. So, you know, of course, some of us had our little immune system were a little low. So, a lot of us were down. Ash cat baby head turned straight. You know, I mean, all sorts of stuff. So, we are all back today. Thank you guys for kicking in there with it, hanging in here with us. Of course, we always thank you guys for your support and continued support with the Devil's Advocate. And, of course, today, I believe we have a guest coming in today. We're just going to wait and see. But, of course, everyone, I want you guys to say a lovely good morning to my illustrious, lovely co-host, Miss Servantique.
Good morning.
What's going on there, woman? Now, you ain't got the
I want to apologize to my audience for being
absent. Know. You just got the boy.
Yeah.
What you doing?
Our sister had to take care of her for a minute. You know, it's all good.
I mean, I'm saying,
you know, still in the background with that tea, though, you know.
Yeah, you do that, but you know,
yeah,
you your boy all
never,
up here. You know, I just want to know, you know, what's my motivational, because I'm getting a little emotional when I get stuck out here. You know, I had the itis. You ain't got the itis no more, do you?
No.
So you ain't got cool, you know, you ain't going to be bringing your... Mm-hmm.
I'm just busy as a bee. I mean, work you got good. Me on 10 right now.
I know.
I got a lot of traveling coming up, and I had to get that approved by my doctor, and it's just crazy right now.
Well, you know, they got me like Tommy. You don't know where I'm going to be working.
Yeah. I was like, I got to hit like 3 cities in the next 60 days, so it's like back and forth and back and forth and back and
well,
forth.
We are glad to have you back, darling.
All right.
And I'm glad to have you here. I don't know. Maybe baby here might get hit day. I don't know. She might still have a cootie. You know, I mean, I think that goat I used to mess with followed her around. But today, I mean... like I said, we're waiting on a guest. So, what do you have? We can do a topic. You want to do trending, Dad Wama? What you want to do, Dad?
First of all, I want to bring some awareness to the public. And this is My Life in Trust Foundation.
All right.
I want to give a big kudos to Dita Director Woods.
That's it.
Yeah.
Somebody stole my belt. See, that doesn't happen when you be gone for. There you go.
And I want to tell everybody a little bit about the mission for this. And it's a 501c3 nonprofit whose mission is reconstructing the mindset of African Americans by inspiring, empowering, and educating for cultural awareness. Basically, community rehab. This is something that every community needs.
Yes.
And I think a lot of our issues that we deal with, that you see in the media, that you see on TV, dealing with police brutality, everything from family to relationships, business, black ownerships, everything can and will be profitable through this, you know, organization. So, however, you can find them on Facebook and newswork.com. And I just want everybody to really, 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 really go to that right now. Okay. My Life News Network.
Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Go to My Life Trust. And stop playing.
Right. Because, I mean, it's a lot going on there. He has some very interesting things.
Very interesting.
One I've taken to. And he's very, you know, a good person. He smiles every now and then.
Yeah, every now and then he smiles. You know, that's our videographer. He over there. You know, he got that Rain Man type of quiet on him. You know? He just goes sit over there smiling. So,
but if you have an organization, however, that you would like to be featured in a news story and would like to work in conjunction with him, you can contact him at 501-291-3560. Again, that number is 501-291-3560 or mynews@mylifenewsnetwork.com.
All right. Well, thank you, T. And again, D. Wood, thank you again, bro. And thank you for your services here with us.
Yes.
We really appreciate
it. It's a blessing.
You know, it really is a blessing to us. So we want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for taking care of us like you do and giving us great video feeds and stuff. Even when I always got my head facing to
even
the
though I have
camera.
I have to keep y'all in line sometimes.
Yeah,
you know, being the only woman here. sometimes when Ashley's out.
Yeah, baby hair.
Because y'all like to double team me when I'm wearing
that. That's right, because you're lucky Stanley ain't here. Yeah. Wait a minute, where's Mike? He drunk again? Mike, you on that stuff, boy?
Yeah, because you didn't see what Mike posted the other day.
Yeah, I see everything that boy. He drunk again. Boy, you on that stuff.
He had every candy in the world in a soaked in alcohol. I was like, where they do that at? I said, now you're enticing candy? Okay.
Yeah.
That was hilarious to me.
So, you know. So, what we got? What we got there, one? What we got today this week?
I want to hit on one subject particularly, and this is concerning our youth. We have a major problem out there dealing with children, and not just little kids. We're talking, I'll say, mainly teens at this point.
Oh, my Lord.
I'll say mainly teens. Let me get through this fast. Okay. We know now everything around our children reflects social media and scrutiny in their day. And, it has been very, you know, effective in households. And if you have a daughter or son who is posting half-naked pictures on their Snapchat, Instagram, Facebook, anything dealing, cell phones, selfies, and everything else, and they have contained these pictures in their cell phones, it is against the law. They are committing a crime. A lot of parents don't know that. They think, you want to see my cute girlfriend? She just got on a bra and some underwear and everything, and they think it's cute, but it's actually against the law. If a police officer or any school official see that, if they're scrolling through their phone and see any kind of picture that is considered nude with an underage child in their cell phone, they can be arrested right there on the spot. So I wanted to kind of bring awareness to a lot of parents to do phone checks, iPad checks, laptops, desktops, anything that you your child has access to. A teenager, I don't care if they all the way to the age of 17 or 18, depending on what state you live in, considering that this news radio station do and can broadcast abroad. So I just wanted the advocates and the public to know, at some point in being a parent or aunt or uncle, at what point do you remove your child's gadgets if in fact you do find that they are maintaining pictures that are, you know, not appropriate with other kids their age, and in fact, you know, what do you do about it? Because you cannot just take their cell phone and say you're on punishment, because they can access that at a public library. So,
T, hold that thought for a second. I think we got a caller. Hello, caller. This is Django's Burger Pit. You go today and buy a burger from us, we'll give you the grease for free. Hello?
Like somebody going to sit here and just eat.
Okay, look. Let me tell you something here, woman. See, I've already had my blood pressure go up because Stanley just showed up.
I just got out.
And now you done called.
I just got out.
You on that? What? You on that?
I just got out.
On bail? What? Where you at?
Well, child, I was driving and I ran into my ex.
Oh, Lord.
Ran into him with the car or ran into him personally? That's Stanley.
Well, I had to pick him at the grill or the truck. I mean, Lord, I had to be discharged. I didn't, you know.
See, that's why I said I set myself up for this every week. Go ahead.
But nonetheless, talking about social media and the children.
And children.
I have a 13-year-old son. And he recently got his iPhone given to his grandmother. And the reason for that is that I'm one of these parents, you have no privacy. You want some privacy, you go get your mortgage and you get your own house and you can have all the privacy you want.
Until I get there,
pretty much. And even still, you don't. I mean, y'all can go talk to the boss lady. She come over to my house. I'm over a certain age. I almost gave it away. Ooh, touch Lord. I have no privacy. She goes in any room of my home. With my son, what I'm noticing with our young people in social media, they're posting fights. They're sharing, ooh, did you see such and such do this? And they're extending it to one another,
mm-hmm.
not being aware that they're underage and you're now in possession of pornography.
Mm-hmm.
So what I did one Monday, because, you know, the weekend passed. One Monday, I was looking at my son's Instagram and his Snapchat and all his little social media, and I'm noticing that school starts, what, y'all, 8:30?
Mm-hmm.
Ends about 3:45. From 8:30 to 3:45, his phone is just shaking and buzzing when they're supposed to be in class.
Mm.
The phone is just shaking and buzzing. I mean, for what? Why? So guess what? You can't have a phone anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Because this is a distraction from everything else.
Mm.
You can't do what's necessary. But you know what? We can't really just blame the children.
No.
Because if you have that inch, you're going to take that mile. As parents, we have to be able to say, okay, you're not going to access these things. You may see them on somebody else's phone. Even now, I found out something. Even now, when you go to certain public libraries, there are certain sites you just can't access.
Mm-hmm.
You can get on Facebook. Instagram is, I think it's Webgram, something like that,
mm-hmm.
on a PC. Mm-hmm. But it's just certain social sites you cannot access on some, at some libraries. But it's just not social media, it's television.
Mm-hmm.
People find it so unusual that my teenage son, he can't tell you what comes on BET. He can't tell you what comes on VH1.
Mm-hmm.
He can't tell you. He doesn't know what Nicki Minaj said to Miley Cyrus. No clue.
Well, can I ask you a question?
I don't even let him get on YouTube.
Jen selling cookies, Girl Scout cookies. Can I ask you a question? They did block Django and the Goat website, right? That's correct, right? They can't get access to that. Can't.
Child, you know what? That right there is illegal in 7 countries. I don't know what you're talking about. I just, no, can't nobody see that. But the thing about it is, as parents, we need to police what our children do.
Jean, let me stop you right there.
Just because the little girl down the street does it.
Let me ask you a question, Jake.
What is it? I don't want to talk about you and this goat.
No, the key words you said, the key words you said was parent. And I think that the whole topic of this discussion involves children who don't have strong parents. And so what do you say
exactly
to, like, let's just use your child, for instance, who has a strong parent, who I'm sure he's friends with many kids who don't have strong parents at home. How do you teach him how to separate that? Rather than being socially outcasted, because we do want him to allow and to grow, mm-hmm. into a young man and to be able to, mm-hmm. fit in some way socially. But how do you teach him the difference of your house versus their house?
That's just the thing. My house is my house, and my son tells his friends that. Mm-hmm. What you do, I can't do. So if I can't be cool with you because I don't do these things, guess what? Me and you are never friends to begin with. Bye.
Mm. That's a hard lesson to learn at
13. That's how that works.
Yeah, very hard.
That's a hard lesson to learn at 13, because at a certain age, you're developing your own personality and you're learning who you are. Mm-hmm. And we have a lot of young people who are not who they've been called to be because they want to be like the next person.
Correct.
Period.
That's correct.
You know, for myself and my son, because I have two, and even with my nieces and nephews, I'm still in the village mentality. Just like when some of my eldest son's friends come over, I tell their parents, listen, if they cannot be disciplined, if they can't be told, watch your mouth, mm-hmm. get somewhere and sit down, they can't visit.
Mm-hmm. Well, Jen,
You just can't.
We gonna hit our topic. So I want you to call back, because I know you will. You going to bring us some more tea a little bit later?
Probably.
Girl, get off my phone. I'll sit around. We'll hit you up a little later. We've got to get into our subject.
All right. Thank you.
Okay.
All right.
Before you make that jump, let me just add a little bit to what Jen said, because I can speak to her from the perspective of being
a father.
A father.
Yes.
And I can speak to her from the perspective of being a grown man that deals with social media issues as well. Bottom line is, if it's something you think you need to hide in a private vault or some sort of something that you don't really want somebody to see, but you're trying to show off, Mm-hmm. Be careful who you show stuff to, because one day they're gonna show your stuff.
Ooh.
And you just got to be—you got to be mindful of, no matter what age you are, that you know you're gonna go through cycles of friends. And so, some of the same folks I kicked it with at 13, mm-hmm. I couldn't tell you nothing about them at almost 40.
Right.
So, just be mindful of that. And then, as a father, I'm gonna just say this. If I catch your little wee wee in my child's phone,
ooh,
it's gonna be hell and hot water, and that's all I can say on Christian radio. You keep a little your little ranking up thing to yourself, and don't send damn nothing to my child, my niece,
damn
this day and age, my nephew either.
Nah.
So,
right.
Yeah, you keep all that to yourself.
Right.
Some of these little girls got daddies.
And sure they quite hostile, some on parole.
Correct.
Right.
So, again, advocates, what do y'all think about this? We're going to go ahead and take a little break, but we're going to go ahead and give y'all the number here. It is. Oh, and by the way, if I get the number out, everyone, Stanley has just entered the building. My pressure has, of course, went up.
Fresh out of rehab, baby. I'm in the building.
He's out of undisclosed locations.
Right. Been sober 13 minutes.
Yeah. That's and took my blood pressure about 20 seconds to go up as soon as I saw him. So, we're going to go ahead and get a number. The number is 855-525-5683. That's a lot of fives, but then hey, $5 foot long.
Yeah,
you know.
I got five on his gas.
Yeah, five. Hey, that's gas money these days.
Boy, you better learn something. Serving them foot longs from the local penitentiary. Right?
Yeah, they are. Hey, we will be right back with some more Devil's Advocate. Stay tuned. All right, folks, we back. Boy, what a day. Stanley is in the house. My girl Servant T is in the house.
Yes.
And we are going to. Now, I just want to clarify something, because the day was supposed to be I Asked the Attorney segment with Powerhouse Attorney, local attorney Jimmy C. Morris. But due to some scheduling conflicts, he's going to be on next week, and we're going to go ahead and have him. We're going to do I Asked the Attorney segment. I'm sorry, because I had posted that on Facebook, and he just hit me up and told me he had a scheduling conflict. So we understand, bro. Go and make your money. That boy like Frank Lucas. Frank.
Yeah, he out there collecting them coins.
I'm telling you, jet setting and euros.
Don't play with my coins.
I'm telling you, boy. Right there, I don't know.
Can't argue with the judge, Carly. So.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
You can argue everybody else except the judge, right?
So we're gonna go ahead and push back I Asked the Attorney segment till next week, and we're gonna have him come in, because there's a very good legal topic I wanted to talk to him about today, which is going on in New Jersey, in case
you
haven't, which is the one about now where cops can now almost arbitrarily, they say it's probable cause, but that's a code word for arbitrarily, search your car upon stops now. They don't even have to get a warrant.
Sorry, sir. You're going to need a warrant for that.
Not in Jersey now.
Well,
I see a Supreme Court challenge on the rise. But anyway, let's go to our topic there, T.
Get out and vote is all I got to say.
That's all I got to say. Get these bums out.
I drive a motorcycle when you're in New Jersey.
There you go.
Right.
Yeah.
Uber.
Or take Amtrak.
Yeah, I love the subway. I'm sorry.
So, T, what's going on in the topic today? So we can go ahead and hit our trend. What's going on?
Okay,
there,
this is a topic that came up. I call it church chat. Okay? A woman has been very promiscuous inside of the congregation. Some say using the church as a dating playground. Imagine that. Going to church, meeting people and dating and bouncing around. Bouncing Betty is what I like to call her. However, from deacons to other official members, this woman don't allow grass to grow under her feet. The married women groups at church asked the board members to ban her based on her on hearsay of her being with their husbands or in someone they know.
Mm.
So a rub. What had happened was
a rub.
Hold on, because you know I'm kind of slow. Let me get clarity.
Get clarity.
The church, women in the church want her banned.
Yeah, nobody else has stepped forward. I mean, even though we see what goes on,
okay.
but it was actually the women, married women group. You know, they have these groups where they congregate, and they asked the board to dismiss her from the congregation because it's it's unchristian-like to have that behavior.
But you want to ban her for sleeping with these men, but you didn't say she was getting raped. You said she was sleeping with the men. Oh, okay. I'm going to take a big gulp on that one.
Oh, DeSanja.
Huh? What?
Wait a minute.
Hold on. Stop the press.
Speaking of church, the deacon and got some flowers.
The deacons and got some flowers some delivered flowers, up here. I'm some jealous.
Earth flowers.
I'm yeah, we all in the card.
The card says, "Dear De Django, thank you for years of love." Signed, Bad.
He done just put it on wrong. The air like,
they wow. The goat can't spell bay. So I get it. So I'm going to take this little pitchfork for the day and keep it moving. But anyway, you did say the woman didn't say that she was getting raped.
I'm jealous. I'm the only woman in here.
She wasn't getting raped in church. She was just right. Knocking them down.
This is my thing. I don't understand how you can ask somebody to be banned out of the house of the Lord. I mean, is it a... See, there's too many rules. Okay. That's why I go to.
Let's just go there for a minute. Now, you're not being a little sweet, little choir director because I guess y'all sound good every Sunday. you ain't banning the alcoholics you put up there to show that your church has compassion for the community. And nor are you banning all these kids because they sagging, but they come as they are because it's church.
Right.
But you're going to ban this single woman for messing with your married man. You might be banning the wrong group of folk in that cluster.
All right.
Yeah.
And you hear my theme song in the background.
Oh, yeah.
Let Bishop Bullwinkle say what I can't say on Christian radio. But y'all better get somewhere and sit down.
Yeah, because at some point, when do you come to the men of the congregation to say your behavior is not acceptable as well?
Right.
And that's where I would have a problem. Knowing my big mouth, I stand up and say it in front of everybody because I have no filter.
Well,
but I don't understand how you can just, point out. I mean, if you get rid of her, here come another bouncing Betty in 2 weeks.
Well, but you can't go to church and pick sins either.
You cannot.
Right. Now,
right.
You want to throw stones at.
Yeah.
And then half the time, in my experience, because, I've been living a while, but usually the folks that's complaining about the cheaters are cheating themselves, just haven't got caught.
Their cheating is different.
Well, for me, it's different because they're not cheating with somebody. Just cheating with everybody. Yeah. They boo faithful.
They'll say he's not married because he's not living in the home, but yeah, legally he's still on paper with somebody.
My papa called it a side chick special. She ain't cheating with nobody but you because you just special.
Until your money run out. But okay.
Your money run out. Or the drink cup ain't got no ice left in it. It's time to get a refill. Told you I just got out of rehab. I ain't quite sober yet, but I'm up. Eyes woke, boss.
Yes, indeed.
Deacon, you ain't got nothing to say about
it. I got nothing to say right now.
You're spellbound because you got flowers from that goat.
He cheesing.
I know when my hotline bling.
I ain't never seen a red in the cheek before. This is a special. A Snapchat moment.
That's a new website. Jeff Snap.
I want to thank those that made this possible.
So you want to talk about the flowers at this point?
Let's go to the topic right quick.
Topic is, ladies, should you send your man flowers?
Purple and gold too. All these cute colors. What it does. Okay.
Glistening all over your body.
What happened with the topic again?
Yeah, he is totally thrown off his game right now. For the first time ever, I've been knowing him a while, and he's never been speechless until now. Let me just make note of whoever sent the flowers. You actually have him speechless right now. So.
Team Gorilla. Okay.
I'm going to get composed.
Okay.
I'm going to get my composure.
Okay.
With the Bouncing Betty situation now, you're right. I agree. I think with that type of situation, you got thought bots to the left of you, thought bots to the right of you, and everybody is being dishonest in the middle. Because, I think Stanley made a good point on Facebook. It's like, if you're going to mess around and kick out, you're going to have to kick a whole bunch of extra people out with her because she's not doing it by herself.
Right.
Yeah.
So
it
didn't
the whole
say she was pleasuring herself in church.
And I had this and it kind of got long, so I'm going to condense it. When I talked about how, so often we talk about the church being a place, a hospital. We liken it to a hospital where people go who are sick, go to get healed. And I said the problem with that is, and we've talked about this, is that you cannot mix carnal pleasure in a church. Because you remember that movie, y'all, Two Can Play That Game?
Mm-hmm.
And remember, one of the first things Alice said in the movie was that, hey, man, he said, if you want to go find you a good girl, where you go? He said, go to church. He said, There's no cover charge. They're going to be there every Sunday after the club, and it's free. So when you go,
and they're going to look their best.
Yeah, and they're going to look their best.
And you ain't got to buy drinks.
There you go.
Yeah. Grape juice is on
they
the
get
house.
That grape juice.
That's
and
crackers. Right. That's right. The grape juice is on
you
the house.
You get a little mini snack. So my thing about it is when you start talking about missing Crown Pleasure, and see, let's not get it twisted here, folks. Don't get twisted the idea of people that are grounded in the word with people that are grounded in God, because there's a difference here. Mm-hmm. Because you have to also understand.